drugs for recreational and religious use. I've done extensive research on this subject, and from experts such as Peter McWilliams and other news articles. So I will first talk about why they are illegal in the first place, and then I'll talk about why we should legalize consensual partners. So the first thing I'll talk about is why they're illegal in the first place. Most of the reason that consensual crimes are illegal is due to fear. People are afraid of a change in lifestyle, and when people are afraid of something, they usually make rules to make other people not be able to do them. Another reason is that politicians like to keep them as issues, so then they have something that they can keep talking about. Government also wants to look good. They want to look like they are taking care of their citizens, but when in reality, cigarettes kill more people than all illegal drugs combined. Now that I talked about why consensual crimes are illegal, next I'll talk about why they should be legalized. So, consensual crimes should be accepted in the legal system because prosecution of consensual crimes is first un-American and second unconstitutional. It is un-American because it puts an unnecessary limitation on people and what they should buy. And how they should live their lives. One example is that most people think that prostitutes are people that have nothing else they can do, and that was their only choice. But some prostitutes actually enjoy their job. The second part is that it's unconstitutional. Most of the basis on the reason they make it illegal is because of mostly trying to establish the basis of Christianity in the legal system. This is unconstitutional because there's supposed to be a separation of church and state. The government is not supposed to try and establish any type of religion, but they still use the basis of Christian beliefs to try and tell people how to live their lives. I'm personally Christian, but as far as a legal standpoint, I don't think the government should be telling you how you should live your life and that one way is better than another. They should try and keep people from killing each other, but not trying to say how they should live. It also is against the freedom of religion, because there are actually some religions that allow adultery, polygamy, and then the religious use of drugs such as peyote. This is another thing that the Constitution says that you're not supposed to do. You're not supposed to say that one religion is over another, and that's why prosecuting consensual crimes is illegal. Also, America can benefit economically. Currently, on the battle on the drug trade, we lose $200 billion on taxes. We spend $50 billion on the war on drugs, and we lose $150 billion in potential tax revenue. Also, 6 million potential jobs are lost. when people are in an economy where they're trying to find any job possible, 6 million jobs, that can help a lot. Also, there are more important issues that we should be talking about than consensual crimes. Currently, police catch only 20% of all violent criminals. That includes murderers and rapists. All the jail cells, they're full. There's nowhere that we can put them because 80% of all people in jail are there because of consensual crimes. Currently, 1 in 4 people are sexually assaulted. 400,000 children are abducted. $100 billion are lost in insurance fraud. 1 in 7 people are illiterate. 14.2% are in poverty. And currently, as everybody knows, there's trillions and trillions of dollars in debt. And one way that we can get rid of that debt is to grow the economy. Creating a new market would grow that economy. Now that we looked at why consensual crimes are illegal and why we should legalize them, let's review everything that we talked about. First, we talked about why consensual crimes are illegal. Then, we talked about why consensual crimes should be legalized. Now that you know more about consensual crimes, you will know why it's beneficial for America to legalize.